begins at 10.
And the whole permitting process was circumvented, and Provident is over there developing this property. And I want a cease and desist order issued immediately.
People in St. Bernard accuse a developer building mixed-income housing of sidestepping the rules. Neighbors don't believe the developer has the proper permits.
And now they are calling for the development to be shut down. WDSU reporter Gina Swanson is on your side with tonight's Big Local Story. Gina?
That's right, Norman. Construction on the development to be shut down at least. But from the beginning, the idea of these four mixed-income apartment complexes has not gone over well in St. Bernard. Now the residents are saying the developer, Provident Realty Advisors, is going around the rules. They want something done about it.
They had signs and flags, and this group of residents is hoping to get a cease and desist order against a mixed income housing development in their neighborhood.
Provident Realty has been given a pass from our own federal government and the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers. Okay, I'm here to expose this to everyone and ask why.
Neighbors say the land the housing is being built on used to have an inhabited duck pond, and when there are wetlands involved, the proper procedure is to get a permit from the Army Corps of Engineers before starting construction. Neighbors don't believe that happened and say the Corps greenlighted the project anyway.
There's some legitimate questions that the Corps should answer that says, yes, we followed our procedure for permitting, or we did not. I don't know that the outcome will be different in the long run.
Neighbors believe any work on the housing units should come to a standstill until the developer has secured a permit.
A wetlands permit takes up to 6 months to get, and us as citizens here, if we were building whatever the building was, we would have to follow the same rules.
This isn't the first time neighbors have objected to the mixed income housing. This development has been a contentious issue in the parish for a couple of years.
That is correct, but that is not what we are here about to voice our concern about today.
At one point, the St. Bernard Parish Council issued a moratorium on the project, but a judge cleared the way for construction to move forward. As for these protesters, they're not quite willing to put the issue of a wetland permit behind them.
Now, we did reach out to the developer of the mixed income housing. Their legal team told us they have no comment on the permit issue at this time, Norman.
All right, Gina, we also called the Corps of Engineers about the permitting process, and so far we have not heard back from them either.